Make up for what you've missed. Mixtape, bar, dinner date, staycation, Friday night, bar, out all night, gym, another bar.
Now it's time to show me your mixtape using hashtag make up for what you missed.
Cause I don't self-medicate. And it burns like a gin and I like it. Put your lips on my skin and you might ignite it. Hurts but I know how to hide it. Kinda like it.
These fantasies started 2 years ago? 3 years ago? When?
2 years ago. It's always the same. It starts the same way.
How? Tell me.
I prepare for the noble war. I'm calm. I know the secret. I know what's coming, and I know no one can stop me, including myself.
Do you target people who have been mean to you or unkind?
I kill people I like.
Can I help you?
Some of them beg for their life. I don't feel sad. I don't feel anything. It's a filthy world we live in. It's a filthy, goddamn helpless world. And honestly, I feel like I'm helping to take them away from the shit and the piss and the vomit that run in the streets. I'm helping to take them somewhere clean and kind.
I'm going to put you onto an Amazon find that you will not want to miss out on if you have lightened hair. This is the Matrix Unbreak My Blonde collection and is an absolute saviour. As I'm sure my fellow blondies can appreciate, it can be an absolute nightmare to keep hair looking healthy. These products are infused with citric acid, which really reinforces those bonds and leaves hair up to 3 times stronger. Along with the shampoo and conditioner, there's also a leave-in treatment which gives that extra boost and protection, and all of the products are sulfate free, which means they're super kind to the hair. So yeah, that is my number one secret recommendation for keeping blonde hair super healthy, and they're available to buy on Amazon now at really affordable prices.
For not returning my bridesmaid's gift after the wedding was canceled. My friend Jessica, 28 female, was supposed to get married over the summer. She asked me and a few of our other friends to be her bridesmaids by giving us gift boxes. They were really nice. Well, Jessica's fiance got a call from her boyfriend and the wedding was called off. Neither one of them knew about each other. We were all just as blindsided as he was. Jessica recently contacted me to tell me that since the trip isn't happening, she wants the bridesmaid's gift back. When I told Jessica that I had assumed this stuff was a gift, so I'd already used some of it, she got really mad and said that I should have saved it for the trip and that I had to reimburse her for the price of all of the stuff.
What a tacky bitch.
Her and the maid of honor, her sister, are talking a lot of shit in the group chat that I'm stealing from Jessica. Am I the asshole?
Oh, I could never take that long to do my makeup. I just do my makeup in 10 minutes and I go.
I know, Karen. I know. I can tell.
I have a movie idea. I know it's been a little bit, but I'm back. So hear me out.
A young woman has spent basically her entire life in the mental hospital. But while she's in the hospital, she gets pregnant and has a baby boy. Soon after his birth, she begins to act normal and stable, so she gets released to raise him. But by the boy's 18th birthday, his mother is very ill. So he went to go visit her, maybe for the last time. But before he left, her last words to him were, "I'm not as crazy as everyone says I am. Trace my steps and come and find me."
What?
The next day, she died. He wasn't there for the death, and she wanted a closed casket funeral. But her words kept playing in his mind. Come and find me.
So he kind of sort of did something really illegal.
He dug up her grave. Inside, he found nothing but her mental hospital bracelet from years ago. So he does what she says. He checks himself into the mental hospital and begins to trace her steps. Is his mother alive? Is this some sort of sick game she's playing? Are there more clues within the hospital walls? Or did the pain of her death cause him to lose it?